expressing my condolences to the family of the deceased. This is a very tragic accident that occurred on that night. However, as we continue to remain transparent as a department, as an agency, we are releasing this video that was captured at the scene by a real-time crime center camera. After I go through the details of what transpired on that night, I will answer any questions that you may have. The accident occurred in Algiers at the intersection of General de Gaulle and West Bend Parkway on Thursday, August 27th, around 9:45 p.m. A senior police officer, Derek Williams, who is a 24-year veteran of the New Orleans Police Department, was en route to his assignment in the 6th District in his department-issued take-home marked police vehicle. Officer Williams was traveling eastbound on General de Gaulle as he approached the intersection of West Bend Parkway. The traffic light for Officer Williams at that time was green. As Officer Williams entered the intersection, a bicyclist, a 54-year-old male, was heading northbound on West Bend Parkway and rode through a red light into the officer's lane of travel, resulting in this very, very unfortunate collision. As per NOPD policy, Officer Williams was required to submit to a drug and alcohol test. The test determined Officer Williams was not impaired at that time. Immediately following the incident, Officer Williams was reassigned pending the outcome of his investigation. Let me say this about Officer Williams as well. He immediately got on his radio and called for assistance, medical assistance, for the deceased. And I can't say, I was on the scene that night. He was visibly shaken. He was really hurt, and he is still pretty much shaken up behind this unfortunate incident. I met with the family on the very next morning after this accident. I also sat along with Chief Thomas, who you see standing here with me, as well as Chief Westbrook, who's standing here with me. We sat with the family and reviewed the video with them and explained to them everything that we have at this time. This is an ongoing investigation being led by our Traffic Fatality Division, more specifically Sergeant Bernard Crowden. And I've, as always, I ask if anyone have any information, please contact us with that information. This is, again, has truly affected that family. This has affected Officer Williams. You know, in talking to Officer Williams that day, you know, he mentioned the fact that, that night, he mentioned the fact that he had never, ever used his duty weapon for anything. And to be involved in something like this where someone has lost their life has truly astonished him. He is hurt. So we pray for the family, and we pray for Officer Williams through this difficult moment. And that's all we have at this point in time. Fatality will continue its investigation with regards to any follow-up. It may take a few months, meaning an investigation into the condition of the vehicle at that time, an investigation into the toxicology of the deceased. Things of that nature has to come to fruition before we are able to reveal or give a full report on this investigation. So I'll answer any questions that you may have at this time. Thank you for that, Sherman. So, you know, normally we would implement our video release policy on officer-involved shootings. As a result of this tragedy, I think it is important, especially today, that we continue to be transparent. And in being transparent, I have authorized and asked that my team implement a new policy. We enhance that policy by any incidents involving a death while a police officer is involved. We will start implementing our video release policy with regards to that in an effort to continue to be transparent. So thank you for that question.
Bob Sig?
Chief, you asked if the officer was still on leave, or I guess it would be technically assigned. Is it assigned to desk duty, or is it on leave? And can you tell us why
Yes, ma'am. So the officer is reassigned not as a result of the criminal investigation or the administrative investigation. He is reassigned for his mental wellness. We want to make sure that our officers are mentally fit to provide the services that are needed from us as a department to our citizens. So right now, he's currently reassigned for his own mental wellness.
Chief, there have been a significant amount of vehicle/bicycle accidents in New Orleans, fatalities, things of that nature. Mm-hmm. Is there something that motorists, bicyclists should learn from what they see today and from past incidents?
I mean, bottom line is just we all have to be more vigilant and attentive in our actions, be it a motorist or a person driving a vehicle or operating a bicycle. We must abide by the state traffic and municipal traffic laws. So if anything I can say to everyone is just being more attentive to your actions while operating a vehicle or motorcycle or bicycle. So at this time, we are unable to determine if there are any distractions by the officers. There's nothing that points to the fact that there may have been any distraction by the officer in itself. Again, and he went through our protocol with the drug policy and things of that nature, and he was found to not be impaired. But we have nothing that suggests that he was distracted either.
Any other questions? Yeah. Go.
Okay. Sure. Before we pivot to that, let's see, Ramon, you have something on this topic before we pivot?
If what I'd ask you just in the session before we went on camera, if you could just repeat that Officer Williams, the reason that Officer Williams remains on desk duty despite the video showing that he was not.
Yes, this is all about his wellness. I mean, this is something that we would do in any situation, officer-involved shooting. We want to make sure that our officers are mentally fit before they go back to regular tour duty.
All right,
so,
before we pivot, any further questions on this issue? All right, go ahead,
Josh. No.
Okay. So I just wanted to get your mm-hmm. thoughts on the action taken by the city council yesterday involving tear gas mm-hmm. policy, and then also on the no-knock warrant.
So with the tear gas policy, we've worked with Councilmember Banks since his inception, since he began the first draft of this ordinance. And putting that together, it does not necessarily, I guess you could say, put a hold on what it is that we have to do. It is still, tear gas is still a tool in our toolbox, but as a last resort, and only to preserve life is how we want to use it. You know, we had this unfortunate incident on June 3rd, something that we will hope would never, ever happen again. But we continue to work with our council members on various ordinances, going into the no-knock warrant as well. Councilmember Moreno reached out to me, and she and I had a discussion, and I am open to that, that further discussion. You know, in many instances, we do not need to have a no-knock warrant. But there may be some circumstances in which we do. I'm not sure of them. I'm not ready to just say yes or no to any of them just yet. This is something that my team has partnered up with her team, and we're taking a deeper dive into what is the appropriate action for us as a department moving forward. I think Danny has a question.
Yeah, this is unrelated. Murphy Business Stories. There was a shooting, it was like Wednesday evening, about 5:30. Apparently, two suspects shooting at each other. One from a car with a high power self style weapon. This is in the 6th, that's South Saratoga, and 7th. Lady we talked to said she had 20 bullet holes in her house. Another might not be a lot of details. Mm-hmm.
No, nothing at this time. This is an ongoing investigation with that particular shooting. But again, if anyone has any information, we ask that they contact the 6th District at 658-6060 or Crime Stoppers, 822-1111. Okay? Thank you all.